Hello everyone, welcome to Talented Developer. In this tutorial we are going to learn how to do a Stripe setup in a Spring Boot application. So first of all, you have to know what is a Stripe. Mainly we are using a Stripe for payment gateway, and it is very huge and they have already created their document, so it is very easy to integrate and they have very good web application, so you can easily track it. So first of all, what you have to do, you have to click here sign in button, and if you don't have any account, then you have to create an account. So you can click sign up. I have already an account, so I'm just going to click continue. After continue, what will be happen, it will be successfully login, and the first screen will be like home. Home is a kind of like dashboard. Here you can see all the reports, like how many customer created, how many payments has been done. So if you scroll down, you can see all this option, and here you can see one option is there, developer, and view test data. So if you are going for first time, try to click only for testing things. So you can just click developer. Here you can see one option is there, API key. So we are going to use one API key. So mainly API key we are going to use to call a Stripe API, so it will perform all the operation. So if you click here reveal test key, it will show my Stripe test key. So we are going to use this Stripe key for the further tutorials. So how you can create a Spring Boot application? So you can either create using any ID, or if you don't want to create, you can just go start.spring.io. So it is mainly a Spring initializer. Here you have to provide all the names. You can give your names, it is not like mandatory in structure, and dependency. If you go here, you can select here a Spring Web, a Spring Boot Dev Tools. If you want for any more things, you can just add the dependency. I have already created a sample Spring initializer application. You can see the link in the description. So I have already downloaded a Stripe payment Spring Boot application. You can find the link in the description. So now I'm going to import this. So I am using Eclipse IDE for my coding purpose. So I'll just click on file, import existing Maven project, and I will try to open that location. So this is our application. So just click on select folder, and you can see here pom.xml. Click finish. It will take some time to download all the dependencies. The project has been imported, and you can see here pom.xml what are the dependency we are using. You can just take a look, and if you are missing anything, just try to import that dependency. And here you can see this is our main Spring Boot application. So every time whenever you are going to start application, it will always take this class. So just test one time, go click run as Java application, and in the console you can see the application is going to start. You can see here is Spring, it is showing, and this is our Spring Boot version, and here you can see our port is running at 8080. So now we need to create one controller. So try to copy this name because we are going to use, and just click here, go new, and in the package just put the same name, and you have to add controller, because what are the package name we have given, the application will always take after that class, right? Now I'm going to create one controller. So now I need to just create a sample controller so we can check it, like either it is running or not. So you have to use annotation rest controller, and I'm going to create one sample API, and it will just return like hello, and we have to define our request mapping, like which path we are going to call. So let's test that. So first of all, you have to stop your server and again try to run your application. So our application is running at port 8080, so please go and run localhost 8080, and here you can see, right, it is printing hello. So now we need to add our API key. So how you can do, So you have to copy this name and you have to open the Java application, and here you can see resource and application.properties. So stripe.api key equal to, so I have added our Stripe key. Please use your Stripe key because this is my account Stripe key. If you have added my key, then it will create problem for you. And after that, we need to read that Stripe API key. So how you can do? So you have to first of all read the application properties. So I'm just going to define one variable here, a string. And if you want to read any value from the property, so you have to use value, then dollar sign, open and close, and just keep the key name. So what is our key name? Key name is this one. Just copy and paste it, just import. So how you can test? Just come and try to add that Stripe key here. So I'm just going to stop our server and let's start once again. So if our API key is working fine, that means like we have added successfully in the properties, then definitely we are going to access by using this API, right? You can see, right, it is same whatever we have added. So now we need to add the Stripe Maven dependency. So how you can do? Just go and search on Google Stripe Maven dependencies and try to open the first link, and you can see the version we are going to use, the latest one. So just copy this one and you have to copy paste that dependency here. We need a Stripe dependency because whatever operation we are going to perform, we need to use a Stripe API. So for that we need to use that dependencies. So in next tutorial we are going to see how to create a customer. So we are going to create one UI also, and in between we are going to also learn how to call our API using the Postman.